When the pimp's in the crib, ma, drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. When the pigs try to get at you, park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. And if a get an attitude, pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. I got the rollie on my arm and I'm pouring Chandon and I'm full of best cause I got it going on.
All right, state your name.
I am Alexandra Sophia Thornton.
That's beautiful.
Thank you.
All right, how long have you been going to Harvest Hall?
8 years. Oh,
that's a long time.
It is a long time.
What is your favorite song?
See, that's a hard one because I have to be in the kind of mood. Because, you know, I love my Beyonce, so I can just go Love on Top, like, if someone asks me off the bat.
Yeah.
But favorite song, I totally love Drop It By Like It's Hot.
Oh, that's
Snoop Dogg.
That's a great song.
My man.
That's a good song.
Yeah, so that's good. That's fun.
That's good.
Yeah.
Do you have a favorite movie or favorite book?
Yes. I'm a huge Dan Brown fan. Wow. So I love Angels and Demons. The book, not the movie. The movie's god awful. I just don't think Ewan McGregor was up to his, you know, standard. But my favorite movie is Shawshank Redemption. I love Shawshank Redemption. That's the movie. Or Bridesmaids, if we're having to choose to.
Yeah, okay. What subject or extracurricular are you most passionate about? There can be more than one, but, you know, just a few.
I'm kind of a widespread person.
You are.
Probably theater. I really enjoy theater.
Why do you enjoy theater?
I don't know. I guess because it allows me to meet people that I'm not, but also bring part of myself to it in the same way. I don't know. I like storytelling, and I guess that's an outlet for that.
Who is your role model in life, and why?
A role model? Meryl Streep. Just because she's such a champion. Everything she does. I love her au naturel look. She's a strong little woman.
Just like you.
Just like me, you know. So it's fun. Favorite moment of high school? That's a long time.
I'm sorry.
That's like 208 weeks.
Are you sure that's 208 weeks?
Yeah, I'm sure.
That's a couple of moments.
A couple of moments.
Just something that comes to you that you feel like was good.
Well, I loved the rush I got when I did my first show.
What was your first show?
Drum Game.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Yeah, that was great. That was a good moment. And then Lily Carver tripped me and I fell flat on my face, which was also fun. I've had a lot of good moments, you know? I don't know.
What do you think is the best aspect of Harvest Hall?
The best aspect? Well, I see Harvest Hall in a very different way than most people see Harvest Hall, because I've been able to kind of establish myself in a lot of different areas of the school. Most people stick to sports or theater or art or anything, and I kind of do it all. So my favorite aspect of Harvest Hall is probably the ability to do everything that you want to do. And you have to be kind of crazy, but I'm kind of crazy. And to be able to fit all that stuff into your schedule, but like the ability to be able to do everything that you want to do and that I'm really passionate about is really great.
What is something that you think you would change?
I'm a firm believer that I think school should start at 9. But, you know, I don't think that's ever going to happen. So,
if you had unlimited resources.
If I had unlimited resources, we wouldn't go to school on Wednesdays and start at 9.
Okay, that's good. That's a good change. Who has been influential in your life up to this point?
I feel like a lot of people. feel like our class in general, like as a body, as a entity, has been very influential in creating, like allowing me to be the person that I am, and kind of accepting me for it. It's kind of an oddball, but that's okay. I'm kind of worried about college though, because you know you don't know anybody. So you go, and am I gonna be myself? I don't know.
Like people like in our grade or teachers, have they changed you like positively or negatively as a person?
I think that everybody I've ever met has changed me as a person. I feel like I pick up something from everybody I know in one way or another, just to try to relate to them or try to not relate to them. I don't know, I feel like I'm this culmination of everything that I've ever done and all these people that I've met. So definitely people have changed me. The better for the worse, but yeah, I think definitely positive changes have occurred on my being from the school. My greatest accomplishment. I think that my greatest accomplishment has been that I have stayed true to myself and not like changed for anybody. That's not like a material thing, like it's not like an award, but the fact that I still like myself after 8 years in this school is a remarkable thing. Just because I don't remember very much from before, and I feel like I've even grown to like myself more as the time has gone on, because I'm so at home here. And I feel accepted by my peers, my teachers, and yeah, you know,
that's good.
That's it.
Is there anything about high school or just in general that you would have done differently or that you regret at all?
No, I'm a big believer in everything happening for a reason. And I think that everything I've done has kind of led to where I am now, and I'm in a good place. Of course, there are, you know, those occasional classes that I, no offense, I wish I hadn't embarked on. But I think that in general, I like everything that I've done, and I've not necessarily been proud of everything I've done, but it's led to proud manifestation.
Is there a class or a teacher that has helped you further develop your passions, or just a teacher that you like or a class that you like?
Rosie Pascal. Definitely. Definitely Rosie Pascal.
Of course.
Oh my gosh. I've been doing art since I was an infant. I was in art classes when I lived in like Santa Monica, and I lived in Washington State. Everywhere I've been taking art classes since I was that big. And I've always loved creating, but when I got to Rosie's class junior year, I totally fell in love with it in a totally different way. And she's been such a positive support system for me, and like both like my personal life and my artistic endeavors. And I honestly don't know where I'd be without her. She's such an amazing woman.
What are a few high school survival tips that you would give to lower classmen?
Oh gosh, you guys. Oh my gosh. Don't overload yourself with everything. I've loved it, but I've also hated it. Just do what you think you have the capability to do, and nothing more, because you will give up a lot for it. And it's great, but I take a lot of sleep to function, and I haven't gotten very much of that over the past 4 years. But survival tips. Don't let anybody sway you. I know they talk about peer pressure all the time, but only do things that you want to do and you feel comfortable with doing, and don't let anybody pressure you into doing things that you wouldn't do like you wouldn't do from your heart, because the only things worth doing are things that you really are passionate about and things that you think will develop you as a person and as a good person at that. So I think that.
Yeah, sure. What has the high school experience in general just taught you about yourself and or other people?
People in high school are not fully developed. So, I think the thing that I've learned most is that I can depend on people, but I can't really depend on people. You know what I'm saying? I've really had to learn that if I want something done, I'm gonna have to do it myself. And if I want it done right, then I'm definitely gonna have to do it myself, because no one is gonna be there to pick up my slack, like, later in life. And high school has just been a very eye-opening experience for me, because I don't know, when you're younger, you see the world as this magical place, which of course it is. It is a magical place, but it just gets harder, you know? And it's taught me a lot, but in a good way. And I feel like I am prepared to walk out of these halls for the last time in 82 days from now. Read that much this morning.
Yeah,
82 days.
Wow.
8 laps, point in 2 days. So, wow. Get ready.
I'm ready. That's great. Is there anything else you would like to say to the world?
The world.
The whole world.
That will be watching this. Hello, world.
What's your future grandchildren that will be watching this?
Oh my, future grandchildren.
Hell, back in my day.
No. Don't be afraid to take a leap. It's the most horrifying experience. Do something you're scared to do, but everything that you will be good, you know? I don't know, I feel like that's been like my leading principle throughout high school is why not? Like Bailey was saying, why not just do something new, do something you've never done before? Because if you don't, you're just gonna stay the same. That's boring. Become a better version of yourself through things that you do, and just create memories, because these are the best 4 years of our lives that we have to cherish forever. But in all honesty, just take a leap. Jump. Life goes by pretty quick, and if you don't stop to take a look around once in a while, you might miss it. So, in the words of Ferris Bueller, take a lowdown. Get an attitude, pop it like it's hot. Bye!